Gracious and holy God, we come before you this morning. Lord, we just thank you and praise you for this time. Lord, we praise you for the opportunity that we have to be here in this service of worship. Lord, we ask that you would open our hearts and our minds to receive the message that you have for us today. In Christ's holy name we pray. Amen. Our Old Testament reading this morning comes from 1 Kings, chapter 18, verses 20, 21, and then 30 through 39. Listen for God's word to you this morning. So Ahab sent a message among all the sons of Israel and brought the prophets together at Mount Carmel. Elijah came near to all the people and said, "How long will you hesitate between two opinions? If the Lord is God, follow him, but if Baal, follow him." But the people did not answer him a word. Then Elijah said to all the people, "Come near to me." So all the people came near to him, and he repaired the altar of the Lord, which had been torn down. Elijah took 12 stones, according to the number of the tribes of the sons of Jacob, to whom the word of the Lord had come, saying, "Israel shall be your name." So with the stones he built an altar in the name of the Lord, and he made a trench around the altar, large enough to hold 2 measures of seed. And then he arranged the wood, and he cut the ox in pieces and laid it on the wood, and he said, "Fill 4 pitchers with water and pour it on the burnt offering on the wood." And he said, "Do it a second time," and they did it a second time. And he said, "Do it a third time," and they did it a third time. The water flowed around the altar, and he also filled the trench with water. At the time of the offering of the evening sacrifice, Elijah the prophet came near and said, "O Lord, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, today let it be known that you are God in Israel, and that I am your servant, and I have done all these things at your word. Answer me, O Lord, answer me, that this people may know that you, O Lord, are God, and that you have turned their hearts back again." Then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt offering and the wood and the stones of the dust and licked up the water that was in the trench. When all the people saw it, they fell on their faces and they said, "The Lord, he is God. The Lord, he is God." Our gospel reading today comes from the book of Luke, chapter 7, verses 1 through 10. When he had completed all his discourse in the hearing of the people, he went to Capernaum. And a centurion slave, who was highly regarded by him, was sick and about to die. When he heard about Jesus, he sent some Jewish elders, asking him to come and save the life of the slave. And when they came to Jesus, they earnestly implored him, saying, "He is worthy for you to grant this to him, for he loves our nation, and it was he who built us our synagogue." Now Jesus started on his way with them, and when he was not far from the house, the centurion sent friends, saying to him, "Lord, do not trouble yourself further, for I am not worthy for you to come under my roof. For this reason, I did not even consider myself worthy to come to you, but just say the word, and my servant will be healed. For I am a man placed under authority, with soldiers under me. And I say to this one, 'Go,' and he goes, and to another, 'Come,' and he comes, and to my slave, 'Do this,' and he does it." Now when Jesus heard this, he marveled at him, and turned and said to the crowd that was following him,